طيب، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الليلة عندنا محاضرة قيمة جدا جدا مع دكتور ناهد محمد الحسن. دكتور ناهد محمد الحسن هي حاليا the head of general adult psychiatry OPD clinic at Amal Psychiatric Hospital. She's also an adjunct professor at MBRU واللي هي افتكر محمد بن زايد محمد بن
بالراشد
راشد محمد بن راشد RUD
يونيفرسيتي.
University. اوكي، بن راشد، اوكي، University. دكتورة ناهد يعني ما شاء الله عليها، يعني she's a very accomplished psychiatrist. She trained and she accomplished the MMBS and MD in Sudan. She also did a fellowship in consult liaison psychiatry in Qatar. She worked in several locations in Sudan where she was the assistant professor in University of Medical Science and Technology. And she was also the medical director for the psychiatry department for Academy Hospital in 2014-2015. She worked also as a consult psychiatrist at Khartoum Hospital from 2013-2014. She was a director of positive discipline program Child Right Institute in Khartoum, Sudan from 2007-2014. And she was the vice president of Sudanese Writers Union 2008-2009. She achieved and she was awarded several awards, including the award of Williams Frederick Memorial International Award in career dedicated in child sexual abuse research, prevention and management from Institute of Violence, Abuse and Trauma in San Diego, USA in 2016. She also achieved the award winner of Dr. Ali Kamal Regional Award for best research among young Arab psychiatrists. She has published extensively, including several papers, books in both Arabic and English language in different fields. And she wrote regular newspaper articles in the field of women and child rights and protection. Without further ado, دكتورة ناهد تفضلي، لأن عندنا محاضرة قيمة جدا جدا اللي هي عن الكلوزابين. وتفضلي دكتورة ناهد.
Thank you so much, Dr. Yasser, for the introduction. I'm like a proud graduate of Sudan Medical Specialization Board. يعني أتمنى لكم كلكم أمسية جميلة. I hope this lecture يعني تجدوها مفيدة إن شاء الله. So today we are going to speak about clozapine. And I will try my best to do this يعني in 1 hour. We are going to discuss overview of clozapine and related concept and pre-treatment workup and clozapine initiation and monitoring. And then we are going to discuss clozapine side effects and management and clozapine drug interaction, clozapine augmentation, clozapine discontinuation. And hopefully we'll find time to discuss few scenarios about cases that you might encounter during your work, inpatient or outpatient. So clozapine is the first antipsychotic known with its effect on refractory schizophrenia. And it is the only atypical because there is absence of EBS and tardive dyskinesia. Clozapine has shown to reduce mortality compared to other antipsychotics. And also clozapine is currently recommended by NICE guidelines since 2009 for use of in resistant schizophrenia, where two antipsychotics have been ineffective, which occur in 30% of cases. يعني البلك of الكيسز يعني our antipsychotics will work only for 60 to 70% of the cases. The remaining 30 to 40% يعني we need clozapine. So we need to know everything regarding clozapine because يعني it is the only drug recommended for resistant schizophrenia. Clozapine improves outcome in around 50 to 60%. So still we have like 5 to 10% of the cases that even with clozapine, they were still having resistant schizophrenia. So we might consider further augmentation of clozapine as well. So despite these facts, يعني there is bulk of patients that needs clozapine and due to side effects of clozapine the delay of doctors of starting clozapine, for example, in research in UK found to be around 4 years. That means patient keeps suffering 4 years and doctors are trying combine many antipsychotic medication without going to clozapine because they are afraid of side effects or they are not comfortable with clozapine and clozapine monitoring. So And I think our pictures are covering, yes, like this. So clozapine is a second generation antipsychotic. I think it was first started in the market in 1956. And but due to side effects of agranulocytosis and recorded many deaths in the States, it was withdrawn from the market. Or it wasn't used for quite a long time, I think, till the Clozaril famous study that compared clozapine to chlorpromazine in a 6-week trial. And they found it really very effective after failure of three different antipsychotics. So, and later on, the interest and the importance of clozapine, several studies like ELCAT studies, the ELCATLAS studies, the SOHO study, and the famous meta-analysis in 2018. So clozapine is proven efficacy. And as we all know, it is that's why it is a second generation antipsychotic that remain the gold standard for the treatment of treatment resistant schizophrenia. It has unique efficacy in patients who have not responded to at least two other antipsychotic agents, include at least one second generation antipsychotic. And we know that the clozapine mechanism of action, it blocks from D1 to D4, and also it has affinity to serotonin 5-hydroxytryptamine 2 receptors and 5-hydroxytryptamine 2C receptors as well. Is responsible for its efficacy in reducing both positive and negative symptoms in schizophrenia. However, due to its significant risk for severe side effects, including agranulocytosis, myocarditis, and seizures, its uses require careful monitoring and adherence to strict protocol. So what we need to know about clozapine, it is a very effective drug, but it is also very risky drug. So we need to know how to start it, how to monitor it, and how to deal with it. So it is FDA approved for treatment resistant schizophrenia. And the definition of treatment resistant schizophrenia is very important. It is defined as a lack of satisfactory clinical improvement despite the use of at least two different antipsychotic agents, including at least one second generation antipsychotic prescribed at optimum dose for an adequate duration, typically 6 to 8 weeks, at a therapeutic dose equivalent to equal or more than 600 milligram chlorpromazine with the adherence more than 80% of prescribed dose. That means we need to make sure the patient was taking the medication as you prescribed it for them and before shifting to clozapine. And also it is known for its effect in reducing suicidal behavior. So it is the only antipsychotic approved to reduce the risk of recurrent suicidal behavior in patients with schizophrenia or schizoaffective disorder. It also very light on cognitive function. It is not like other medication that can affect the cognitive function. And it is off-label use in Parkinson's disease, the psychosis in Parkinson's disease, and bipolar mood disorder. Sometimes we use it also for the bipolar mood disorder. Please feel free if you have any question while I am giving this lecture, you can ask me at any time. I needed an interactive session. So you diagnose resistant schizophrenia and you decided to give clozapine. You need first to discuss this option with your patient or their guardian, because clozapine, you need to take a different detailed history with the patient. So you need to ask very important question before starting. You need to inform your patients thoroughly about what is clozapine and what are the side effects and how the initiation might take longer. I'm not sure about, because doctors are working in different places and if each hospital might have its own policy. Okay, but here, for example, our hospital policy is to initiate clozapine as inpatient, because at least at the beginning till we reach the therapeutic level with clozapine, we need the patient to be under observation. But sometimes even in the outpatient clinic, when the patient, for example, is stopped clozapine and we need to restart initiation, we might reinitiate again in the OBD level. So we need to be aware what type of questions we need to ask. So you have to have like a document that is special for clozapine if you are using electronic system or paperwork. You need to have clearly a clozapine special note. So to make it easy for others also that they might see your patient and follow him or her up. So they need to know exactly when exactly did you start the clozapine and all the information regarding the patient age and the diagnosis and the indication of clozapine, whether for schizophrenia resistant or for schizoaffective disorder or for bipolar mood disorder. And in your workup, especially in the history, you need to ask precisely about epilepsy, because we know that clozapine at certain level might induce seizure. For people with epilepsy, they have higher risk. And also you need to make sure that they don't have any cardiovascular issues. And with physical examination, yani we need to know a baseline, pulse, blood pressure, waist circumference, and weight and body mass index, because clozapine has also metabolic risk and it has other side effects, cardiac or others. So we need to know what is our baseline. And there is like certain templates for baseline lab results. Yani, the timetable might be a little complicated based on different guidelines, but we need, yani, for example, in my clinic, I make it easy. I put it a template in a hard plastic cover or a QR code. So me and my patients can scan the code so they will have it in their own mobile, because we need our patient to be engaged in their own yani care, yani not only just to tell them what to do, because it is a very complicated timetable, but with frequent use and follow-up, you will be able to memorize it. So there is a special test also in the baseline, ECG, CRP, and also troponin. Because if any side effects appear later, we need to know our baseline. What was there and what has changed? So still with the preterm workup, we need to do frequent blood test. You know, in the first 18 weeks, we need weekly total white blood cell count. And then after the other 6 months, it will be like every 2 weeks, and then it will be monthly. So vital signs checks should be every time the patient visits a clinic, we need to do blood pressure, pulse, temperature. And if it is initiated in the inpatient, we need daily, and sometimes, especially at the beginning, in the first 6 hours with initiation of clozapine, we need every hour to monitor pulse and blood pressure and temperature. Whenever your patient visits your clinic after initiation clozapine, you need to ask and to check for the side effects, the special side effects, because our patient usually do not volunteer sharing those side effects. And if you didn't check and you didn't ask, you are going to miss them, and some of them are really serious. So you need also to know that if the patient is stopped, because our patients, sometimes they lack insight, sometimes medication are given by relatives, and sometimes the patient might resist take the medication. The relative and the one who's taking care of the patient and the patient themselves, they have to, you have to tell them from the beginning that if they stop clozapine more than 48 hours, that we need again to restart and initiate from the lower dose. So this is very important, because also it has a serious consequence. And I will just keep telling patient education and the family education and the caregiver education is a gold standard in working with in starting clozapine, because this is the only thing that can guarantee the success of the process. Because without their education, their vigilance about the side effects and the care that the patient has to take and the several measures they have to be aware of, okay, they might be poor adherent to medication, and they might stop it due to side effects that not recorded or not reported to the doctor. So also you need to counsel your patient about side effects, and you need to encourage their adherence. and not only to the medication, but also to the scheduling monitoring that you are going to share with them. So for pre-treatment workup, we need to do a thorough medical history, and we need to do a vital signs baseline. We need to do also labs baseline, and it has like a timetable that at the baseline for blood, for example, as I said, weekly or every 2 weeks as per the guidelines, but also for the other side effects of metabolic risk. And so, and every 3 months, every 6 months, 9 months, 12 months, it has a certain timetable. It is easy to print it out and to keep it with you, because I think it's very difficult for you to keep records. So for the cardiac, as I said, an ECG, echo only if it is indicated, and CRB, and also the troponin. Neurological, if the patient has history of seizures, we need to do EEG. And be aware that EEG in any patient using clozapine, in most cases, is abnormal. So you need to know your baseline first. So I don't want you, this timetable to, like, this table to scare you, but the goal, in clozapine initiation, as much as you can, you need to start very low and to go really very slow, because most of the side effects of clozapine are dose dependent. So usually, as per the guideline, here our hospital policy and mostly guideline, we started with 12.5 milligram. And then there is this table, okay, you need just to start at the beginning. And the most important thing, the first 6 hours after starting, that's why it is better to start the dose at night, because if any like dizziness or sedation or hypotension happening, the patient will be sleeping, and you don't need to check him every hour about pulse, blood pressure and temperature. But if you start in the morning, you need to make the patient aware that they might develop those side effects, and you need to check them regularly in the first 6 hours. So we need, when you measure blood pressure, you need to measure it in different setting, standing and sitting, and you need to check the temperature, as I said, at the beginning, every 30 minutes, and even after each dose. Treating team should be informed, because you are covering, for example, inpatient. The nurse has to know exactly when to report and what to report. If there is any drop in blood pressure more than 20 millimeter mercury, diastolic or systolic, the pulse was over 100 beats per minute, there is fever, temperature excess of 38.5 degree, service user refuses observation for greater than 3 days, patient is clearly oversedated, any other adverse effect is intolerable, and bowel movement records per patient caregiver. This issue is very important, because our patient, either they are very psychotic to tell exactly about their bowel habits, or to report if they have constipation. So the nurses has to observe that. There is weekly CBC, as I said, should be carried out. Most of the side effects of clozapine are dose dependent. That's why it is very important to watch for this, for the, and to monitor for clozapine level during the initiation or the induction phase. So following initial titration of we need to measure, it is very expensive, by the way, clozapine level, and sometimes even here, for example, it can take 2 weeks to have the results. But you need to be aware that there is certain incidents that we need to put to measure clozapine level. For example, when you titrate initial large dose, or there is change in smoking habits, or you are suspecting toxicity or non-adherence, or patient is not responding to clozapine, you need to know why it is not responding. The clozapine level is, the normal level is between 0.35 milligram per liter to 0.5 milligram per liter. This is according to most prescribing guidelines. The risk of seizure will increase after 0.5 milligram per liter, and the risk of toxicity as well. يعني if it is 0.75 milligram per liter, the risk of seizure and complication and toxicity will increase. And whenever you have like a level more than 1 milligram per liter, you have to be careful and consider decreasing the dose of clozapine if it is applicable, because we are afraid of hepatotoxicity. Clozapine, because also due to its mechanism of action and the wide blockage of different receptors, it has also drug interaction. And there is some drugs that share the isoenzyme system with the clozapine, and either they induce the enzymes or they inhibit the enzymes, and that affect the level of clozapine. Medication like carbamazepine, for example, it is an enzyme inducer and it reduces plasma clozapine. Smoking also, it is an enzyme inducer and it can reduce the level of clozapine. But you have to differentiate between smoking and nicotine replacement therapy, electronic cigarette, because they don't do that effect. Some medication like fluvoxamine can saturate the liver enzyme and increase clozapine plasma level. So normal plasma level, as I said, 0.3, 0.5 to 0.5 milligram. So do you have any question before going further? Are you there?
ممكن تعيدي لنا الثيرابيوتيك ليفل.
0.3, 5 to 0.5. This is the therapeutic level. يعني if you remember lithium, it is something similar to lithium level. You see, it is all below 1. Okay, and the problem is start after 1. يعني this is can make it easier to you. Is it clear?
أيوة شكرا.
Okay, thank you. So I'm going to share my PowerPoint presentation in a PDF with you all, so you can have those information and you can go through them. You need to remember them, because honestly, this medication, sometimes you need to augment clozapine. Sometimes you need to address side effects of clozapine, and you are going certainly to encounter those choices. So you need to be aware of the drug interaction between valproate, benzodiazepine, SSRIs, smoking, phenytoin, and rifampicin, and ketoconazole, omeprazole, caffeine. يعني, you know, our patient usually they are excessive smoker, they are using excessive caffeine, you see. So you need to know those things, because they have drug interaction and they are affecting the clozapine level. Taking them or stopping them. يعني most of the hospitals now, they are having a non-smoking policy, and the patient inside the hospital might use nicotine replacement therapy or something like this, and when they go outside, they go smoke again. So the level is going to drop. Put that in mind, because you need to adjust the dose sometimes accordingly if the response, the clinical response is not what you are expecting. And you consider those medication. And sometimes patients, they can use antibiotic while they are smoking, while they are using caffeine. And all these interactions affect the clozapine level. So I'm not going to do the test now. I will go to the clozapine side effects. So far, if you don't have question, we can discuss. Now we know that we need to take detailed history. We need to educate our patient. We need to be aware of how to initiate and how we need to observe the patient, especially in the first 6 hours, for any side effects, sedation, hypotension, especially tachycardia, or any other idiosyncratic reactions. And we need to to know what type of side effects we need to be vigilant about. And I just want you to know, clozapine have many side effects, but some of them are really serious. Some of them are like something you can treat. So I will just go. I want you to see this this table, because it make it easier for you. You see here, there is very common side effects and there is very rare side effects. The very common side effects, you will see it, the percentage is more or equal to 10%. And those very common side effects like tachycardia, sialorrhea, nausea, dyslipidemia, weight gain, impaired glucose tolerance, and the metabolic risk is one of the very common side effects. The hypersalivation, nausea, tachycardia, sedation, and urinary incontinence and fever. And the very common are just more than or equal to 10%. The very rare side effects are less than 0.01. This is myocarditis and cardiomyopathy. We need to be aware of them because they are fatal. Yani, it is rare, but it is fatal. So we have common and uncommon side effects, but you see the range. It is 10% or below 0.01. This is the range. The common side effects is less than 10% and more than 1%. And those like hypertension, constipation, seizures, myoclonic jerk, neutropenia, OCD. And the uncommon side effects are less than 1% and more than 0.1%. This is hypotension, agranulocytosis, myocarditis, and cardiomyopathy. As I said, they are very rare. But this is in brief. You see, they are all either very annoying and very disturbing to the patient, or very serious and fatal as well. So we need to be aware of this table. As I said, I will share my PDF with you, so you will have this easy, organized, to be memorized. So I will go to the hematological side effects. And in hematological side effects, we need first to identify high risk patient, and we need to know, be aware of benign ischemic neutropenia, and I think all Sudanese, we have high percentage for benign ischemic neutropenia, and we have to know the monitoring requirement, how we are going to measure the total white blood cell count and so on. Managing needle phobia, some patients they will refuse to give blood, and when to consider rechallenge after neutropenia. As I said, clozapine can induce neutropenia and can induce agranulocytosis. Neutropenia defined as absolute neutrophil count less than 1.5 times 10 to the power 9. This number is really very important, yani, because you need to remember this, because based on this, you are going to have decisions regarding going with clozapine or stopping clozapine. So the neutropenia occur in 2.7 of patients. And this is the agranulocytosis defined like this. Yani, neutropenia is below 2,000. Those at higher risk include, there is difference between neutropenia and agranulocytosis. Neutropenia occur in young age, African, Caribbean, low baseline white blood cell count with previous clozapine neutropenia. The problem is that if someone with benign ischemic neutropenia, for example, and you start clozapine, third of them will develop blood disgrace. Recent initiation in clozapine, as I said, the first 18 weeks, we need to measure the total white blood cell count and absolute neutrophil. Okay, I want you now to help me address this scenario. We have a 28 years old patient on clozapine, for 6 weeks, has an absolute neutrophil of 1.6 times 10 to the power 9 on a routine lab test. So what is your immediate action based on this absolute neutrophil result? Anyone? Just try. يعني you have someone that the absolute neutrophil was 1.6. What are you going to do?
I should monitor. السلام عليكم، أنا دكتورة ليلى.
أهلا وسهلا بكم.
I should monitor her closely two times per week. If clozapine is still if sorry neutropenia the white blood cells still within the range more than 1.5, I will still continue clozapine. If it dropped less than that, less than 1.5, I will stop the clozapine immediately.
Excellent, Leila. يعني there is traffic lights sign for clozapine. يعني we have the green, we have the amber color, and we have the red color. And as Leila said, the red color is when it drop below 1.5. And still this 1.6 is within the amber color. And we are not looking at neutrophil alone. We will look also at the total white blood cell count and the platelets. So what are the criteria of stopping clozapine due to blood test abnormalities? Leila also helped to answer that question when drop below 1.5. How would you counsel the patient regarding the risk of agranulocytosis and future monitoring? Because whenever it is amber color, the patient has to test the absolute neutrophil twice per week, and you need to follow him or her closely. And sometimes you can, يعني, if you think this due to a benign ischemic neutropenia or something like this, you need to consider sometimes starting lithium. So honestly, this is what I do personally with my patient. Because I need to give them the benefit of doubt, I will add lithium and I will see while I'm measuring if it is affecting the blood or no. Because if it is continued drop down, then this is an idiosyncratic reaction that has nothing to do with other causes. It is mainly due to clozapine and we need to stop clozapine. So the
دكتورة بس معلش ممكن تعيد النقطة الأخيرة دي
يعني لما يكون عندك مريض يعني their absolute neutrophil is 1.6. It is still amber color. It is not 1.5 or less. So there is still a room that you can try add lithium, for example, because the lithium, this is what we do for benign ischemic neutropenia. Because if it drop below 1.5, and by the way, it is not only clozapine. I have here many patients sometimes on Cipralex, on other medication, they can develop like agranulocytosis as well. So يعني, be aware some medication also can do that. You need sometimes to introduce lithium to give the patient the benefit of doubt that this reaction is not idiosyncratic reaction to clozapine. But if it is, it will continue drop. So at that time, you need to stop clozapine if it drops further below 1.5. So is that answer your question? So, okay. Agranulocytosis defined as an absence of circulating. Sorry?
Excuse me, regarding the criteria of stopping the clozapine when we reach the red line, 1.5 neutrophils, what about the level of total platelets, total WBCs and platelets?
Okay, this is, I'm going to share the next slide to share with you the traffic light, so you will be aware of them in details, okay? So as I said, agranulocytosis defined as an absence of circulating granulocyte, here neutrophil. The bone marrow shows an absence of myeloid precursors. common at initiation of treatment. يعني usually at the beginning of initiation of treatment you will see this 80% in the first 18 weeks because it is like idiosyncratic reaction, so you will see it earlier, especially in the first 18 weeks. But despite that, you know, because it can happen later as well, that's why we continue the blood testing as far as the patient is taking clozapine. 0.8% develop agranulocytosis, especially of Asian origin. So this is one of the risk factor being Asian. Younger patient less likely to develop agranulocytosis. Younger patient can develop neutropenia, but agranulocytosis will happen with people with older age, more than younger age. So if your patient has needle phobia, you can give anxiolytic prior. Sometimes you can give them alprazolam or something like this just to calm them down. We can use an anesthetic cream to reduce the pain and a lighter needle like butterfly needle. I don't like this finger breaking. It is really painful. And it is advisable, of course, to take all the sample in one session because people with needle phobia, they will not come again to do the blood test. يعني all يعني really the main challenge is with clozapine is the rigorous work and monitoring, taking blood samples, making the patient to comply, to come as weekly to do the blood test. يعني and usually those patients are resistant to schizophrenia, still having psychosis, and the most of the care will be يعني taken care by the family. This is the traffic light system you asked about. You can have it with you in the PowerPoint, but you need to know the green light, that means the white blood cell count is more or equal to 3.5. And the neutrophil is equal or more than 2, you see? And the platelets are more than 50,000. This is a green result. But if the neutrophil is more or equal to 3, and I mean the white blood cell count, and the neutrophil is equal or more than 1.5, and the platelets are more than 50,000, this is amber color. Only what we need, we will dispense the medicine and with caution and repeat the blood twice weekly until either green or red. If it is red, we will stop. If it is green, we will continue our monitoring as usual. So the red, and this is we need to memorize by heart because this is where the risk and the disease will come. It is the total white blood cell count will be below 3, and the neutrophil count will be below 1.5, and the platelets will be below 50,000. So do not dispense or administer, stop clozapine immediately. And sometimes you can find drop, yani even worse than that. You need also to take care of the patient. Sometimes we can put patient yani under observation because agranulocytosis, they can develop infection and so on. So how do we manage neutropenia? We need to consider switching to another antipsychotic medication, reduce or stop other medication causing neutropenia like sodium valproate, for example, lithium at level greater than 0.4 millimol. As I said, it is 0.3, 5, 2, 0.5. This is the therapeutic level. So if lithium is more than 0.4, increase white blood cell count with benign ischemic neutropenia. If you give lithium, the tablet of lithium is 400. You can give 400, 600 milligram usually. Then you will achieve lithium 0.4 millimol. So lithium doesn't prevent agranulocytosis. This is very important. a granulocyte colon stimulating factor injection. There is injection to stimulate the colony, so it can يعني produce the granulocyte, but by the bone marrow, and this is also doesn't prevent agranulocytosis, and it has يعني theoretical risk of leukemia, and it need a hematologist. يعني we as a psychiatrist we don't do that. We don't give that injection. But if the blood drop seriously, we need to refer to hematology for second opinion, and if they advise this, they can give to the patient. Okay. Any question? So there is question here. يعني I have patient develop red color. They are really having psychosis, and the only medication was working was clozapine. Do we re-challenge with clozapine or not? Sometimes if you are very sure this is idiosyncratic reaction, it is advisable not to re-challenge. Because يعني with re-challenge, يعني the neutropenia will occur usually typically within 2 weeks or even and it can be very severe. So it is not advisable. Cardiovascular يعني side effects can be tachycardia, hypotension or hypertension, myocarditis, cardiomyopathy, and venous thromboembolism. If you have any question, just ask, okay? So this scenario, we have a 32 years old male with treatment resistant schizophrenia. Is started on clozapine. On day 5, he reports feeling dizzy and experiencing a fast heartbeat after standing up. What could be causing his symptoms, and how should you adjust the titration schedule? Anyone? What is this? What is he having?
Probably postural hypertension.
Yes, it is a postural hypertension. Okay, so how do you adjust the titration in this case? يعني for example, you are starting 12.5 and then you reach 25 day and evening. Then whenever the patient is developing postural hypertension, you need to measure the blood pressure, the patient is standing and sitting, and you need to slow your titration. You can hold the titration in the same dose, okay, or less. And you will not go with a regular schedule you are already put from the beginning. So just hold or decrease the dose a little and wait till the patient tolerance improves, the blood pressure is improved, then go again. يعني as I said in the beginning, the rule with clozapine to be very safer is to start very low and to go really very slow. And just do not rush increasing the dose quickly. And you need to continue to do the blood pressure, of course, to do that. And it is hypotension. So we will do the common interventions we do we increase the fluids, the salt, sometimes intake in the diet, and so on. So to improve the blood pressure. And we will advise them to stand slowly and to remain still and then to move slowly. And we can, if the patient is impatient, we can tell the nurse that risk of fall and to educate them when they have this hypotension, how they have to move till their body adjusts and they can continue walking. So if the patient has tachycardia, okay? So tachycardia really is very, as we said table, that it is a very common side effects of clozapine. It is common in the initial period and may settle after 4 to 6 weeks. And the main issue when whenever we have tachycardia, we need to exclude other causes of tachycardia, whether it was agranulocytosis, whether it was myocarditis. يعني we need to exclude the serious side effects of clozapine. That's why we need to check other symptoms of chest pain and fever. يعني if the patient develop heart failure, clozapine must stop. We need to do investigation whenever we have tachycardia. We need to check the vital signs, fever, hypertension, signs of heart failure, and ECG. And also we need to do يعني a CRP and sometimes even troponin if there is indication. يعني you measure, you are not sure, do it. It is safer to do it. The management, as you all know, is beta blocker after excluding myocarditis. This has to be after tolerance developed. If tachycardia persists, consult cardiologist. You see, so tachycardia is pulse more than 100. So if the patient has pulse more than 100, we can give beta blocker. It is better to wait a little. يعني it is common to see it in the first of four and 6 weeks, as I said. And if we excluded the all serious side effects, يعني do not rush to give beta blockers immediately because the patient already in the beginning, they have hypotension and the beta blocker might aggravate more hypotension. So يعني hypertension or hypotension, rapid change of blood pressure may occur on initiation of treatment or following dose increase. يعني this is a time when you need to be really very cautious whenever initiation or increasing the dose. The management is to slow titration, okay? And if it is high blood pressure, we can consider antihypertensive medication like ACE inhibitors and the beta blockers. Beta blockers can help too. And if the patient has hypertension and has tachycardia, beta blocker is good for that. And it's protective for the heart. For hypotension, tolerance will develop 4 to 6 weeks, manage postural hypotension and dizziness by standing slowly, especially after meals, and in the morning, increase dietary salt and fluid intake. We usually feel clozapine side effects start the non-pharmacological intervention first. يعني do not rush. يعني the patient already, they have serious medication. يعني and the rule usually, if we are able to manage a patient with one medication only, this is the golden rule. But sometimes we might augment with other medication or treat side effects. So start non-pharmacological intervention first. The other side effects is myocarditis, inflammation of the heart muscle, often after 2 months of starting treatment. The symptoms will be like chest pain, palpitation, shortness of breath, and fatigue. And on examination, you might find fever, arrhythmias, tachycardia, signs of acute heart failure. Investigation, CRP, troponin, ECG, and ECG, we will find diffuse T wave inversion and sudden ST segment. And this is, يعني, questions, you will find it a lot in the best of five or questions. يعني the abnormalities of ECG, myocarditis, يعني inversion on clozapine. So, how many types of troponin do you know?
The common here, the common in Sudan is troponin H and troponin T, as I.
Troponin, we have T, I, C, okay? So the most important indicative for the myocarditis is like troponin I, okay? So when you request troponin I, and troponin I is this is the troponin that inhibition of actin and myosin, يعني contraction of the heart muscle, okay? So monitoring and management of myocarditis. As I said, at the beginning, if you do baseline troponin, okay, and ECG, and echocardiogram. يعني if you are suspecting it, you are going to do it. Because sometimes the troponin, if it was higher, for example, old myocardial infarction or something like this, you need to know your baseline. Okay? You need, if you are suspecting there is changes, you need to do weekly troponin. يعني وهي دائما بتشتغل every 7 days, يعني as baseline after 7 days, 14 days, 21 days, 28 days. And then after 28 days, we can do it every second day for 28 days. And we do the vital signs. If troponin was found like 2 times the upper limit, okay, the CRP greater than 100 milligram, stop clozapine immediately. Echocardiography, refer to cardiology. يعني if you measure troponin and you found it 2 times the upper limit and the CRP greater than 100 milligram, stop clozapine immediately, do echocardiography and refer to cardiology. Okay. So cardiomyopathy, as I said, myocarditis and cardiomyopathy are very rare side effects. Okay, and the percentage is 0.02 of patients in UK. Later in therapy, usually the cardiomyopathy will happen later in therapy, not like the myocarditis that happened in the first 2 months. يعني more than 8 weeks can happen anytime and follow chronic course. Presenting features can be asymptomatic, or we can have signs and symptoms of progressive cardiac failure. Management, stop clozapine, echocardiography, and refer to cardiology. The venous thromboembolism risk should be identified before and during treatment. And preventive measures like anticoagulant and compressing stocking used in patients at high risk. يعني sometimes if the patient is obese, if the patient is limited mobility, if the patient is a smoker, if the patient like that, and even يعني you need to do the assessment. يعني usually, especially if the patient is inpatient. For gastrointestinal side effects, we have like hypersalivation, and hypersalivation often wears in at night, would be a very common complaint, by the way, from clozapine. Patient, they will come and they will be very embarrassed. And especially if they are going to work or they are doing things, they will complain of hypersalivation. It wears at night. We are afraid of aspiration pneumonia because it's a huge amount. It's not something less sometimes. And it may improve over several months. It is dose dependent. And as I said, most of the side effects are dose dependent. Use minimal effective dose and asymmetric dose distribution. And as I said, non-pharmacological intervention first. يعني patient complaining of hypersalivation, we can split the dose and give them the larger dose in the morning if the hypersalivation is more at night, and the less dose in the evening. It is better to use the minimum effective dose of clozapine. That we can add sometimes if it is really large morning and evening and the patient is embarrassed about it and consider stopping clozapine, we can add anticholinergic. And we can add hyoscine hydrobromide, it is lacking evidence, but it is used, okay? And the problem with hyoscine, it can worsen drowsiness, constipation, and cognitive impairment because it's anticholinergic. It will have the whole side effect that anticholinergic might do. Pyrimidine, you know, this is a muscarinic receptor antagonist, also it is anticholinergic. There's other medication like glycopyrrolate. We don't, yani, it is not yani, found in many hospitals. You can use celpride, emicelpride, and probenzaline. By the way, yani, when you are considering clozapine and augmenting other medications, yani, sometimes your augmentation can help the psychotic symptoms and at the same time, the side effects profile. So if you are checking the side effect profile very carefully you will be able to select the right medication. And for example, someone having OCD, having hypersalivation, and is still psychotic despite clozapine, if you add Cellbrite or Emicellbrite, can treat all those side effects and can help the psychosis as well. So a patient reports excessive drooling, especially at night after starting clozapine, 50 milligram twice daily. What are some non-pharmacological and pharmacological options to manage hypersalivation? I just want to check if you are following me or no. Quickly.
Non-pharmacological, Leila Tani. Non-pharmacological, gum at daytime, plus el pelo, perdón.
Sorry, late voltage, no, in the morning, you will give me
gum at daytime.
الجم بيعمل شنو يا ليلى؟ الجم is a stimulator, صح؟ الجم ده نديه لما يكون في lack of salivation عشان يعمل stimulation للسالايفيشن. لكن patient already عنده هايبر سالايفيشن, تعملي له شنو؟ يعني patient with hypersalivation, يعني it is better انك انت قلنا النون فارماكولوجيكال. اول حاجه هو بياخد 50 مللي جرام بي اي دي, يعني نحن ممكن نشوف اذا كان الهايبرسلايفيشن هو مور ات نايت, يعني ممكن الدوز حقه النايت نقللها, نديه 75 مورنينج ونديه 25 بالليل, يعني تو سبليت الدوز ونخلي less دوز ان ذا ايفنينج. دي ون اوف ذا نون فارماكولوجيكال. مرات بترفع المخدة بتاعته يعني شوية عشان ما يحصل له اختناق وهو نايم. يعني how would you explain the cause of this side effect to the patient? If pharmacological intervention is needed, what option can be considered and what are the risks? Anyone? And you need to explain to the patient that يعني إنه الكلوزابين can do these side effects. And it is annoying, لكن it has treatment. Okay, and we can explain to them how we can يعني split the dose, and if this didn't work, what we have other options, this medication, and usually discuss those options with the patient and let them choose if they want to go to the medication or they just want to wait a little. So some of the other side effects of GIT is like nausea. And as I said, nausea is one of the common side effects of clozapine. And it is caused by the anticholinergic side effects and the delayed emptying of the gas of the stomach. Hypersalivation increase appetite. An effect on the hypothalamus may also contribute to nausea. يعني hypersalivation, the increase of appetite, those side effects are connected. يعني when you find hypersalivation, you might find nausea as well. And it increases in the first 6 weeks and often residing later. You can use hyoscine hydrobromide. يعني if you have nausea and hypersalivation, hyoscine can help. So this scenario, if clozapine-induced constipation is serious, and as it can lead to ileus or bowel obstruction if untreated. يعني constipation, by the way, one of the very distressing side effects of clozapine, and usually patients, they will not volunteer. They will just stop the medication. It is painful and it is distressing, And sometimes can lead to serious side effects, can do bowel obstruction, paralytic ileus, and so on. So the treatment include osmotic or stimulant laxative, the lactulose or lacena. Consider regular stool softener if needed. يعني we can encourage the fiber diet from the non-pharmacological side effects, increase fluid intake, avoid the type of food that يعني can make يعني worsen the constipation. Advise the patient to increase fiber intake, as I said, drink plenty of fluid and remain physically active to support bowel function, exercise, and all these issues. So, يعني constipation is very common, often neglected, affect adherence, can lead to bowel obstruction and paretic ileus, as I said, not like other clozapine side effect, it persists. يعني لو لاحظتوا انا قبل بتكلم عن انه some side effects بتختفي بعد شويه. When tolerance develops, some of the side effects will disappear. لكن الكونستيبيشن and hypersalivation, both of them they persist. Not like other clozapine, hypersalivation. The constipation and urinary incontinence. Those are the side effects that they persist with clozapine. So do chart in inpatient setting. Ask patient. لازم في أي زيارة يجيك البيشن بتاع الكلوزابين to ask them if they do have constipation or no. Try non-pharmacological intervention. As I said, the dietary hydration and exercise. And finally, if you don't have senna or, for example, lactulose. Okay. I think you are aware of the metabolic risk of clozapine, olanzapine, quetiapine. Yes? نمتوا يا شباب ولا شنو؟ So that's
يا
why
دكتورة، بس
اتفضل.
معلش، بس من نقطة، بس في حاجة أنت قلتيها مرتين وفيها زي لخبطة بس بسيطة. أنت قلتي
جدا.
ال 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 persist side effect that will persist the constipation or urinary incontinence or the constipation
No, no,
or
no.
hyperexertion.
ال constipation and urinary incontinence ده نوع السايد
أوكي.
افكتس اللي بتقعد في الكلوزابين. يعني
أوكي.
يعني مثلا مرات النوزيا الهايبر سلايفيشن ممكن تتحسن، لكن ال
ايوه
ايوه
تمام.
لانه يعني انتم بتعرفوا مع many medication whenever you start for example SSRI some type of antipsychotics بتظهر بعض السايد افكتس، لكن within 2 to 3 weeks some of those side effects will يعني مع التوليرنس ديفلوب يعني بتقل او بتختفي. لكن يعني في some side effects will persist. يعني الاجرانولوسايتوزيس طبعا عارفين اذا حصلت حصلت يعني. فلانها ايديوسنكريتيك رياكشن. في بعض السايد افكتس دوز ديبندنت، مرات لما تقلل الدوز لما كده يحصل تحسن في الحاله. لكن في some side effects will persist زي الكونستيبيشن والكونتنس needs intervention whether pharmacological or non-pharmacological. الميتابوليك ريسك يعني I just want you to يعني it's a very يعني يعني serious side effects. People they will start gain weight on clozapine on olanzapine on quetiapine especially in the first 16 to 18 weeks. يعني دي اللي بيكون فيها rapid increase of weight and with increase of weight of course يعني يعني الريسك of metabolic syndrome is risk of يعني establishing diabetes. And with diabetes, people will they will have hypertension, cardiovascular disease, and sometimes renal disease as well. So, يعني make it a routine for all of your patients to do vital signs. And at base level, you need to do the waist circumference, you need to do the body mass index, and to do the blood pressure. And you need to do يعني برضو في timetable خاص بالmetabolic syndrome. The timetable يعني you have to do as baseline. You see a first month, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, 12 months. And then you can do every 6 months and annually. You have to know this. يعني لو ما لو صعب عليك تحفظها في البداية ممكن تعملها في جدول وتخدها معاك لما يجيك البيشنت. يعني نحن بالنسبة لنا هنا عشان في الكترونيك سيستم يعني ممكن تعمل اوتو تكست وتمبلت جاهز كل مرة بتسجل فيه. لكن you have to do it. يعني because it will be negligence if you didn't do this. And you affect the patient health and well-being. And also, يعني part of the investigation, very important to do a glucose random and hemoglobin A1C, the lipid panel, liver function test, renal function test, and CRP. And also it has a certain timetable. فال weight gain is an important side effect. Third of the patient weight increased by 7%, especially in the first 6 months. يعني it is not an easy number. No, non-pharmacological diet, exercise, occupational therapy program, and CBT, cognitive behavioral therapy. Yeah, those are the first intervention to do with weight before going to medication. And then sometimes we can prescribe metformin, aripiprazole. Sometimes can, when you augment the aripiprazole with, yani for example, patient has weight increase, has problem with sedation. If you augment with aripiprazole can help both the weight and the sedation. And also topiramate, but the topiramate, you know, yani it can affect the cognitive function. So unless we don't have other options, it is better to consider يعني topiramate. So dyslipidemia. For dyslipidemia, you can try الستاتين ولا الفيش أويل ولا الفايبريتس. يعني على حسب النايس guideline 2014 الفايبريتس. الفيش أويل and fibrates better to use when only triglyceride increased. لأنه مرات تلقى triglyceride and cholesterol. If cholesterol, you need to give statin. But only triglyceride, you can give fish oil or fibrate. Note that they cannot decrease risk of cardiovascular disease. يعني الفايبريت والفيش أويل. Okay. And statin can protect the heart. And can decrease the cholesterol. Hepatic side effects, elevation of liver enzymes, بقدا occur in 50% of patient. عشان كده لازم يكون عندنا baseline liver enzymes. لأنه ال percentage is high. يعني لكن spontaneously resolved over 13 weeks. However, cases of hepatitis and liver failure were reported. Discontinue clozapine if liver enzyme raised threefold. Bilirubin is raised, hepatitis or jaundice. يعني انت بنحب نعاين كل الليفر انزيمز البيليروبين ليفل وبنقرر على اساسه يعني this is serious ولا لا. لانه الاوردينري ارتفاع اللي بيحصل في الانزيمز بيحصل في 50% of the patient. If liver enzymes increase, we need to re-challenge with caution. يعني the risk of rapid reoccurrence is high. Okay, any question? So, other side effects of the CNS like sedation, seizure, and myoclonic jerk. Okay, قبل أنا قلتها لو الكولازابين ليفل وصل above 5 دائما الريسك اوف سيزرز موجود حتى لو البيشن ما عنده هيستوري، لكن طبعا البيشن اللي عندهم هيستوري اوف سيزر هم ات هاي ريسك. So for sedation, sedation can be troublesome. يعني انا يعني I have one patient, she's a lawyer, she's on كولازابين. يعني السيديشن مزعجة يعني. ف and it will be worse especially when starting clozapine. It can reduce within few months. As I said, some side effects can disappear مع التوليرانس. But it can lead to poor adherence to medication, cessation of treatment, and poor quality of life. المانجمنت, as I said, start low and go slow. Reduce or stop other sedative medication. لأنه نحن مرات عندنا habit of يجي البيشن ندي كولوزابين ندي بنزودايازابين وكده, والبنزودايازابين are really very very risky with كولوزابين لأنها ممكن تعمل respiratory depression. ف we need to be very careful. فما في داعي, هو أصلا very sedative drug. You don't need to add any medication. في بعض المديكيشن برضو بتزيد السيديشن زي الصوديوم فالبرويت. سيديشن is dose dependent. You can use minimal effective dose or check clozapine level. You can try asymmetric dose distribution with larger dose at night or add aripiprazole in low dose can improve sedation. As I said, aripiprazole in a low dose can help. الاريبيبريزول ده مرات لما تديه 5 ملغ بس عنده benefit كويسة يعني, سواء كانت للويت سواء كانت للسيديشن, فit is really very helpful. ودايما احنا يعني خدتوا في بالكم الاسيمتريك دوز دي, انا بديه صباح وبديه مساء. عايز البيشن يكون صاحي الصباح بديه كتير بالليل ودي القليله بالصباح. This is a really very serious side effects. يعني the seizures and 5% of patients on clozapine, those over 600 milligram, can develop seizure. EEG in patient on clozapine is frequently abnormal, even in absence of seizures. عشان كده لازم يكون عندنا baseline مرات إذا كان ال patient عنده history, family history of seizures ولا history of convulsions. يعني أحسن أعمل له ال EEG. The effect is dose dependent with risk increase among patient with history of seizures or head injury. Patient can develop myoclonic jerk on clozapine and that put them in further risk for seizures. Treatment is the same. However, lamotrigine can exacerbate the myoclonic jerk. يعني lamotrigine is anti-epileptic. لكن لو عندك a patient عنده myoclonic jerk وعنده seizure, انت لما تعالج السيزر انت you will make myoclonic jerk worse. فلاماتروجين is not a drug of choice لو كان البيشن عنده myoclonic jerk. A treatment of seizure, many factors may reduce threshold for seizures. Medications such as antidepressant, lithium, anticholinergic, and other antipsychotics. ودي حاجة مهمة جدا لأنه يعني انتوا بتدوا الكلوزابين هو اساسا lowering the threshold عنده risk of seizures, بتدوا ليثيوم عشان الاي جرانولوسايتوزيس ده فيرزرينج, فلازم نكون very careful مع الدوز, يعني الدوز بتاعتنا, لانه الريسك بتاعت انه بيشن والليثيوم عن كلوزابين انه يحصل له سيزر لو مشينا اعلى في جرعه عاليه عالي. برضه البيشن بتاعنا مرات بيكون عندهم هايبوناتريميا, عندهم ووتر انتوكسيكيشن ومشاكل تانية في الالكترولايت امبالانسز اولسو كان يعني بريسبيتيت السيزر, ولا البيش اللي عنده هيستوري بتاع ابليبسي. يعني it is better not to go for كولوزابين, لكن اذا اضطرينا له لازم نكون very careful, ومرات حتى الناس بده بروفيلاكتيك انتي ابليبتيك. اوكي, so for prevention we need to do the blood level, وعشان نكون عمليين يعني حتى هنا even يعني في سنترز وفي امكانات وكده, لكن ما بنعمل الكولوزابين ليفل الا بانديكيشنز محدده. سوري someone is talking, في حد عنده سؤال؟
معلش ممكن نرجع ممكن نرجع للسلايد السابقه بعد اذنك؟
شور اها, what is your question؟
يعني هنا مثلا الميديكيشن انه مثلا ندي الانتي ديبريسنت والليثيوم وانتي كولينرجيك, النظر انتي سايكوتيك, ندي النظر انتي سايكوتيك يعني
نو نو نو, دي 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 الميديكيشن دي الحاجات اللي بتعمل ريديوز للثريشولد. يعني انت مرات بيكون عندك بيشن مثلا بياخد كلوزابين وانت اديته ليثيوم عشان مثلا الاي جرانولوسايتوزيس, لكن لازم يكون في بالك اذا انت يو اوجمنت من سكيزو افكتيف ديس اوردر ويز اس اس ار اي فور اكزامبل, ولا مثلا يو جيف ليثيوم ولا انتي كولينرجيك ميديكيشن, كل الادويه دي مع الكلوزابين they will reduce the threshold, معناتها بيعرضوا البيشن للريسك بتاع السيزر اكتر. عرفتها؟
يس يس
ايوه ايوه ده دي والالكترولايت امبالانسز, انا بتكلم هنا عن الحاجات اللي بتعمل مور ريسك تو سيزر. اوكي ولا هيستوري اوف ابيليبسي, البيشن اوريدي عنده ابيليبسي, يو ار موست ويلكم. So the prevention, as I said, monitor the blood level. لكن the blood level لازم نكون نعمل حسابنا إنه مرات ما بكون عندنا إمكانات ولا لحد ما تجينا النتيجة بتاعت the blood level تاخد 2 weeks. فالصحيح دائما لو سألتوني just low dose and go very slow. We use the minimum effective dose. ما في داعي للهاير دوز, الهاير دوز في الكلوزابين unless needed the patient tolerating it without side effects. لأنه أنا كل ما أرفع أنا بخط البيشن في more risk. Consider introducing prophylactic. يعني في بعض السكولز بتقول إنه إذا البلازما ليفل more than 0.5 ولا الدوز بتاعت الدواء بتاعت وصل 600 مللي جرام أحسن أدي معاه prophylactic. خلاص؟ Following seizure, لما لو حصلت لو البيشن جاته convulsions وهو كولوزابين لازم توقف الكولوزابين at least لمدة 24 ساعة. اوكي, من الميديكيشن اللي احنا بنديها كبروفيلاكتيك.
يا دكتورة ناهد, السلام عليكم.
عليكم السلام.
انا ريهام, بس في النقطة بتاعت إنه السيزر لو جات مع الكلوزابين إن إحنا المفترض نوقف for 24 hour. طب الانيشيشن الانيشيشن بتاعه المفترض يكون by half a dose صح؟
الويندو بتاعتك 48 اورز، ودايما لما
اوكي.
تيجي تبدي وكان ستارت هاف الدوز، ولا هو لسه ممكن يستحمل الدوز بتاعته عادي.
اوكي.
اوكي،
يعني
نحن عشان تو بي مايند وذ تايم، دكتور عبد الغني بيقول لي الزمن. اها،
اوكي تمام
فليتفضل
يا دكتور. انا بس كنت عايزه افهم يعني هل شرط ان يرجع لنفس نص الجرعه ولا لا، ممكن يرجع للجرعه بتاعته القديمه
ممكن
عادي؟
ترجع إلى الجرعة، لكن طبعا يعني شوفي أي كيس is different. يعني لما يكون عندك كيس بتاع، يعني بتشوفي كان كيف التحمل بتاعه بتاع الانيشيشن، قدر يمشي فيه كويس، ولا ممكن تبدي بالهافا دوز على حسب معرفتك بمريضك. وعشان كده بقول الدوكيومنتيشن is very important، لأنه من الأيام الأولى كان في سيديشن، كان في هايبوتنشن، كانت في سايد افكتس. فلما دايره يوقف 24 ساعه لازم نبدا ثاني بحذر شويه. لكن انا ما
اوكي
ملزمه ان انا ابدا بنص الجرعه ولا بالجرعه كامله الا بعد 48 ساعه، قبل كده
اوكي
ممكن
تمام
ابدا عادي.
شكرا يا دكتور.
العفو. فالميديكيشنز اللي احنا بنديها للسيدر زي الصوديوم فالبرويت، اللامتروجين، التوبيراميت، وطبعا افويد الكربامازبين، لانه الكربامازبين والفينيتوين يعني عدا انه انزايم انديوسر وكده، الا انه الكربامازبين مثلا بيأثر بيسوي الاي جرانولوسايتوزس، لانه طبعا عنده بلاد ديسكريزي افكت. خلاص سريع نمشي عشان الزمن. الاذر سايد افكت زي الفيفر واليورينري انكونتيننس اند يوريسيز والاو سي دي والباروتيد سويلينج، ودي النقاط الأخيرة، والويزدرول اوف كلوزابين هقول عنهم سريع كلام. أهم حاجة في الفيفر، لما نقيس التمبرتشر إذا 37.5 يعني بنعمل يعني الفيفر مانجمنت العادية، لكن إذا وصلت 38.5 أنا بحتاج برضو تو هولد الكلوزابين، لأنه أنا بخاف من شنو؟ بخاف برضو إنه دي ممكن تكون أي جرانولوسايتوزيس، صح؟ أو ممكن تكون شنو؟ ممكن تكون مايوكاردايتس. فأنا لازم أعمل certain investigation. الفيفر حاجة مزعجة، هي بتحصل لكن بالذات في first 3 weeks، بتحصل في نسبة بتاعت one in every in any 20 patient بيكون في واحد فيهم بتحصل له مشاكل زي ده. فالمانجمنت اوف فيفر زي ما أنا قلت، إذا كانت 37.5 ولا 38.5. أوكي طيب، اليورينري افكت بتاع الكلوزابين بيحصل في 1 in 5 patients، ممكن يحصل لهم انيوريسيس. يعني شوفوا النسبة مقارنة بالفيفر، واحد في ال20 دي واحد في الخمسة، يعني very common، very distressing, persistent, embarrassing. و non pharmacological intervention first، limit the fluid intake بالذات بالليل، avoid before bedtime، avoid the diuretics زي الكافيين والالكحول، and try to use alarms to void before waiting, use a minimal effective dose, asymmetric dose splitting, non-pharmacological first. بعد ذاك الفارماكولوجيكال انترفينشن كان بي الديسموبريسين، الاوكسيبيتونين، السولفانانسين، ولا الترايهكسفينيدايل والافيدرين اللي هم الالفا اجونست والاميتريبتيلين. يعني دي الميديكيشنز اللي احنا ممكن نستخدمها للانيوريسيس. معلش انا بمشي سرعه، لكن لو في اي حاجه just stop me. بقى الاو سي دي ده، يا اما البيشنت بتاعنا اوريدي عنده او سي دي، احنا عارفين زي 5% اوف البيشنت بتاعنا الاو سي دي ممكن عديل تو ديفلوب سكيزوفرينيا. فالاو سي دي ده ممكن البيشنت اوريدي عنده او سي دي، ولا الكلوزابين بتاعنا هو اللي عمل له الاو سي دي. الكلوزابين كان انديوز او سي دي في 10% اوف بيشنت، كان بي ديلايد اور انسيديوس اونست فريكوينتلي اند ريبورتد. يعني العيانين انتوا لاحظتوا بتاعين الاو سي دي ديل اخر ناس بيجوا المستشفى، كان بي ترانزيت resolving over 3 weeks or may persist, can be relieved by increasing the dose. حاجة غريبة صح؟ مرات لما تزيد الجرعة أو تقلل الجرعة ممكن يختفي. المانجمنت use a minimal effective dose ولا dose reduction proven to reduce the symptoms. ونبدأ بالـ CBT first, cognitive behavioral therapy first intervention. بعد ذاك حتى تكونسيدر الاس اس ار ايز وكده، زي ما قلت يعني هو ورد الكلوزابين بالسايد افكتس، ما بكون داير ميديكيشنز كثيره معاهم. الاس اس ار ايز بيتر توليريتد ذان تراي سايكليك، طبعا التراي سايكليك مشاكلها الكثيره والكاردو توكسيسيتي وكده. يعني مرات بندي الكولومبرامين اذا ده كله ما نفع، كوشن فور دراج انتراكشن لايك فلوفوكسامين، طبعا لانه دراج انزيم انهيبيتر. وزي ما قلت لكم السيلبرايد، الام سيلبرايد والاريبريزول، يعني بيشن عنده اوريدي سايكوزس، انا ما داير ارفع الجرعه بتاعت الكلوزابين شديد، عنده او سي دي، عنده سيديشن، عنده هايبر سلايفيشن، فانا بدي سيلبرايد او ادي اريبريزول. اوكي. اذا حصل باراتيدي سويلينج، يعني في الحاله دي انا بعمل بوقف الكلوزابين واستخدم مينيمال افكتيف دوز، ومرات في كومبينيشن اوف بنزوتروبين انتيرازوسين لعلاج الباراتيدي سويلينج. انا هديكم الباوربوينت ده عشان تقدروا تشوفوا السايد افكتس بالتفصيل. اهم حاجه لو انتوا البيشن خلاص قررتوا توقفوا الكلوزابين، ابارت فروم حاجه زي مثلا السيزرز ولا الاي جرانولوسايتوز اللي احنا بنوقف فيها ابربتلي الكلوزابين، انا اي اذا it is better to plan for stopping كلوزابين واعمل very gradual withdrawal، والاسترول المفروض يكون over 1 to 2 weeks to avoid شنو الريباوند سايكوزيس والريباوند كولينرجيك افكت. يعني لكن زي ما قلت في الاجرانوسايتوزيس المايوكاردايتس اللايف ثريتنينج كونديشن، however patient has to يعني stop and monitor closely for relapse of psychosis and الريباوند انتيكولينرجيك افكت فالكولينرجيك افكت. وفي الحاله دي نحن دايما لما نوقف suddenly better ندي البنزودايزبين ونرجع لل previously used antipsychotics. اوكي. ده الجدول هديكم لو مع الباوربوينت عشان تقدروا تتذكروا انه سايد افكتس الكلام الكثير والخوف الشديد من الكولازابين هذه سايد افكت، لكن it is serious side effects مع ال starting low going slow وال close monitoring of patient ال heavy education اللي انا بعمله ليه. كولازابين really is a very good drug. Just you need to know everything about it عشان وفي البداية ممكن حتى يكون عندك جداول بتستعملها لحد ما تتعود على ده. طيب أنا سريع يعني بمشي في الحاجات اللي أنا ما قلتها. طيب دي عندنا patient 40 years old female patient who has been on clozapine for 3 months misses her dose for 2 days due to travel. What is the recommended approach سريع for resuming clozapine in this patient?
She can start it on her usual dose.
More than 3 days?
لا لا no, not just for 2 days في السيناريو مكتوب 48 hours.
ما هي أي patient more than 48 hours you have to start من البداية ما بنبدأ
أيوة ما هي ما more than 48 صح؟ هي 48 ولا؟
لا هي عمرها 40 years old female. كانت
لا
على الكلوزابين 3 months for 2 days misses her dose يعني تمت التمرير.
اوكي هنبدأ نعملها titration. ايوه we start to titrate her.
ايوه هنبدا ري انشيشن من البدايه زي كان بادين من اول جديد. اوكي
نعمل تيتريشن سريع افتكر ما بالضروره
طيب.
ايوه ما في نفس
الفريكوينسي اكوردنج تو موزلي هيكون 3 ايام اليوم الاول بنص الجرعه اليوم الثاني
ايوه
جرعه اليوم الثالث الجرعه
هو انت بتعمل الانيشيشن لكن زي ما قلت لكم ارجعوا للدوكيومنت اللي عملتوه عن البيشن بتاعكم في الاول والسايد افكتس بتاعته والتولرنس بتاعه للانيشيشن فاست ولا سلو. يعني ده بيديكم جايدنس حول انه از ات سيف انا امشي سرعه ولا لا. يعني اي صحيح في رولز عامه حول انه بعد 48 ساعه احسن انا ابدا انيشيشن من اول جديد لكن ممكن امشي اسرع لانه هو يعني جسمه متعود وانا عندي هيستوري حوله قديم يعني. اوكي. والبريكوشنز اور مونيتورنج ستيبس. طيب لما هل انا بحتاج اعمل اي تغيير ولا بمشي في جدولي القديم؟ اي كان يعني المونيتورنج زي ما هو يعني اذا انا بفحص كل مرتين في يعني كل اسبوعين بواصل زي ما انا يعني. اوكي لانه الكوشنز اللي عملناها البريكوشنز اللي عملناها دي بس عشان السايد افكتس بتاعت الريبيد تايتريشن اللي بتحصل لكن مش انا بحتاج ابدا من البدايه اي حاجه. اوكي دي قلناها دي برضو الاجرانوسيتوزيس قلناها. طيب البيشنت ده 45 years old male on clozapine 300 milligram daily decide to quit smoking after his last blood test which should يعني which showed clozapine plasma level within the therapeutic range. How does the smoking cessation impact clozapine level and why؟
يعني
قرر
increase
يوصل
the level.
اها اوكي، يعني السموكينج ولا عدمه اللي بيزيد
السموكينج
الليفل.
سيزيشن كان increase clozapine level.
اكسلنت، السموكينج سيزيشن كان انكريز الكلوزابين ليفل، فبالتالي انا لازم اعمل حسابي يعني اشوف اذا البيشنت كلينيكال تولرنت للميديكيشن، ومرات قد احتاج اعمل كلوزابين ليفل عشان اتاكد انه هو ما مشى للحته اللي انا بخاف منها above 0.5. So طيب انا يبقى لي ياسر في زمن نعمل الكويشنز سريع نشوف تيست النولج بتاعتهم.
وهي كده غايته إذا بيسهروا أنا ما عندي مشكلة.
خلاص ممكن نبعت لكم بالمناسبة، يعني نبعت لكم الأسئلة.
شايف في ناس عايزين.
خلاص هيك هي 10 كود كويشنز فيهم 6 بيست اوف 5، سرعة كده نعملهم. بتقدر تشير الفايل يا ياسر؟
هاي كده دقيقة من عندي ثواني.
لو عندكم أي question meanwhile you can ask.
عندي اقتراح، طيب بما انه في مشكلة في الشير، انه الأسئلة تتعمل على شكل جوجل فورم، زي الجوجل فورم اللي بتنزلها دكتور ياسر، تتعمل وتكون within 24 hour، بتظهر الريزلت عندكم، بعدين تاني الفيدباك ممكن ترسلوها لنا في الجروب، في جروب الإعلانات. يعني دي فكرة عشان الناس الدايرين والما دايرين.
هو يعني الغرض منها يعني انه بس الناس يعملوا الدسكشن ده حولها عشان بس يتذكروا، لكن يعني يو كان يعني وي كان سيند يو ذا فايل اند يو جاست، يعني لانه بتنبهك لما تيجي تقرا انه دونه على الاسئله اللي ممكن تجيك ودونه على الاشياء اللي ممكن تواجهك اذا انت شغال مع اي بيشنت يعني. اوكي طيب، مين وايل دو يو هاف اني كويشن؟
بس هنا دي ظهرت ولا ما متخيل ليه؟
لسه ما ظهرت لي.
دقيقة
بارك anyone has any question يا
ظهرت
جماعة؟
صح؟ ظهرت يا بص
اوكي سمعني بس هنا انا دقيقة.
معلش يا شباب سهرنا بيكم.
ظهر هنا؟
بص لو سمحتي بس انا عندي سؤال، انا مين؟
تفضل.
في الحاله بتاعت انه احتجنا لاوجمنتيشن ويز مود ستابلايزر لما
أها
يكون ليفل 0.5 او ماشي اعلى،
أها
طيب والبيشن في ميل وزي ما حسي ذكرتني بسطنا انه شنو انه البريك هو الشويس الاول، طيب بالنسبه لنا في حالات الفيميل احنا نغير لشنو الافضل؟ لو كان في فترة ممكن إنه يحصل هنا جانب بتاع بريجنانسي وكده.
ياسر رايك شنو في هذا؟ اسمع ده يقول اصلا الحياه كومبليكيتد وتجي وتبي مور كومبليكيتد، لكن يعني نحن دائما طبعا وي بالانس، يعني وي بالانس الريسك مع النيد بتاعت الاوجمنتيشن، يعني وبعدين الحاجات بتاعت البريجنانسي وكده الناس زي كان بلان اند زي كان ايديوكيت اند زي كان بريبير، لكن يعني وي دونت بريفير طبعا اوف كورس صوديوم فالبرويت ولا لاميتروجين ولا كده في الفيميل في الفرتايل ايج والمريض وخايفين انه يحصل بريجنانسي. يعني الفينيتوين برضو it has side effects، لكن في النهايه وي جاست يعني الناس ممكن تدي فوليك اسيد، تدي صوديوم فالبرويت، وممكن تنقص الدوز بتاعت الكلوزابين يعني للمينيمم افكتيف دوز. رايك شو يا ياسر؟
انا افتكر زاد، حتى افتكر عن البوبيوليشن، انت منو اللي حيجيك اساسا بكلوزابين ريزيستنت وريكوايرز اوجمنتيشن، فيري سيك بيشنت، فيري اكستريملي فيري سيك بيشنت، فهنا
صحيح.
البرايورتي بتاعتك الكنترول بتاعت السايكوزس. انا ما بقول لك انه ما مهم انه الواحد يختار مثلا التشويس بتاعت البريجنسي ولا لا، لكن وي توكن اباوت ا فيري ديسفانكشنال بيشنت، فالديسكشن بتاعت البريجنسي شي از ليس لايك تو بي ايبل تو اندرستاند الموضوع ده، ولا شي از ليس لايك تو بي انجيج ان ريليشن شيب to have a baby من الأساس، يعني مثلا يعني ما أقول لك إن الموضوع ده ما ريسك فري، لكن بس الـ population بتاعتك أنت this is a priority هسه بيكون
أوكي. شكرا لفضل العزيز.
واضحة هسه هنا الشير ولا ما واضح هنا؟
أنا تصدق بالنسبة لي ما واضح، واضح لكم يا شباب؟
واضح أيوه
طيب
واضح.
عليك لا، انا عايزه واحد فيكم يجري السؤال الاول، انا ما شايفه اي حاجه، لكن اجري السؤال الاول عشان نشوف الحل شنو مع بعض.
دقيقة أوريكي
سأل.
حاجة كده، خليكي أوريكي شيء، خليني أنا أفتكر أنا عارف المشكلة عندك وين.
انت عارف ان ذاتي ممكن افتح هنا واحد من
لا
الشباب
أنا
يجري لنا
أوريكي،
السؤال الاول.
مشكلة وين، أوريكي مشكلة وين. كده دقيقة كده، كيف واضحة؟
انا هفتحها من الـ الفايل عندي، ما في مشكلة. هيا يا شباب، واحد فيكم يجري لنا السؤال الأول بسرعة عشان تمشي تنوموا. أها.
Which of the following is not used to relieve obsessive compulsive symptoms caused or worsened by clozapine treatment? Aripiprazole, chlorpromazine ولا ما اعرف شنو الثاني،
كلوميبرامين،
نوزابامين،
كلوميبرامين.
كلوبرامين، cognitive behavioral therapy، فلوكسيتين، اولانزابين. I will go for الاولانزابين.
اولانزابين، اكسلنت. So question 2.
ما في زوري جران حقلا. Which of the following is the most appropriate to reduce the risk of grand mal seizures with clozapine? 1. Aripiprazole, 2. Carbamazepine, 3. Lamotrigine, 4. Lithium, 5. Phenytoin.
لاموتريجين.
لاموتريجين.
اوكي.
اوكي طيب. Which of the following antipsychotic may be used to treat clozapine induced weight gain؟
Aripiprazole.
اها
Celebrex.
اها
ايوه
زبراسيدون.
او زبرازيدون ممكن.
اها طيب. البيريزينابين is commonly used to treat which
الهايبر
psychotic؟
سالايفيشن.
اكسلنت. وشنو بيشتغل كيف؟ ماسكرينيك، ماسكرينيك
سكرينك.
انتاجونيست.
اوكي
So which of the following ECG finding may be seen in myocarditis؟ عفوا
diffuse
معلش
to
كده،
leave
بعد
inversion of ancestral ST segment.
اكسلنت. Which of the following is not a risk factor for clozapine induced neutropenia؟ clozapine induced
induce
neutropenia
neutral
مع agranulocytosis، African Caribbean ancestry، higher
long age
clozapine doses، pre
young age
existing.
young age
number age.
young
اوكي. اليانج ايج، ما قلنا اليانج ايج نحن،
لا
او
اليانج ايج والافريكان كاريبيا مع النيوتروبينيا.
مع النيوتروبينيا. وانت السؤال شنو؟
ايوه فالسؤال نوت، فبالتالي هي اللي يكون البريفيوس لو
اوكي
لو ويت، هم هيكونوا ما في يعني ما هيكونوا من الخيارات. ف
اوكي
previous clozapine induced
بريكس
neutropenia.
يس. ايوه
is
I
not
will go for
clozapine
the
dose كيف
also
يا شباب؟
الهاير
كلوزابين
clozapine
دوس.
dose.
اوكي
ايوه، لانه هو ذاته ما دوز ديبندنت. So delayed gastric emptying is worst in the first 6 weeks of treatment with clozapine. True false.
True.
True true. Hypersalivation is typically worse at night.
True.
True. True.
Constipation is minor adverse effect without any serious consequences in clozapine related
False.
patients.
False.
Okay,
False.
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 Recommended monitoring for clozapine treated patient included weight, BMI, fasting plasma glucose or glucose tolerance test, hemoglobin A1C, fasting lipids and liver function test.
True. True.
True.
True. Okay, state glycoside is the first line oral anti-diabetic agent in clozapine treated patients.
False.
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 False. Non-pharmacological.
Yes. Yes.
The same
Non-pharmacological.
antibiotic medication can be used for both seizures and myoclonic jerk.
True.
False.
No, no. False. No, false.
Oh,
Yes.
yeah. قبل قلنا شنو؟
قلت
قلنا
قلنا
الهيموجلوبين
انه في
وارزينين. ايوه
الاجرانيولوسايتوزيس والكاربامازيبين لانهم عندهم بلاد ديسكريسس فما بنقدر
لا لا لا،
نستخدم ولا شيء.
الهيموجلوبين قلنا والوارزين المايكلونيك جيرك، عشان كده ما
يس
قلنا كل
يس.
الاسم. طيب الاريبيبريزول كان يوزد ان لو دوزز تو ريديوس سيديشن.
ترو ترو
ترو.
ترو
ليث
ترو
يم يوز مي ريديوس ذا ريسك اوف سيزر.
False, false.
فولس.
Reduce the risk of agranulocytosis بس ما السيجر. يقلل ال...
هو ريديوس الثريشولد،
بيزيد
بيزيد السيزر.
اي اي لكن دي false. Yes.
طيب كلوزابين should be withheld if the temperature of fever is more than 37.5.
False. No, false, false.
Which of the following is not used to manage clozapine induced in ureses? Asymmetric dose splitting with a small morning dose, desmopressine, limited evening fluid intake, oxybutynin, use the minimum effective clozapine dose.
Desmopressin.
لا.
نستخدم الديسمبرسين الأوكسيبيوتيتينين ده
لا ما عندك الانرجيك
ايه ايه
ايه ليه
ايه سمي
ايه للناس الحريفين بتاع
ايوه
الامتحانات ايه ايوه
ايه دي الاستيديشن ايه الاستيديشن ايه في حالة
ايوه
الاستيديشن
exactly for a green result the wild يعني البلود مونيتورينج must be performed ليش نو ده regarding blood monitoring blood monitoring must be performed weekly for the first 2 months for a green result the white cell count must be more than or equal to 3.5 times 10 to the power 9 and the neutrophil count more or equal to 2 times 10 to the power 9 If an amber result occurs, the dose of clozapine must be reduced by half. In patient with benign ischemic neutropenia, blood monitoring threshold is reduced by half. Neutropenia usually develops, develop after the first 18 weeks of treatment.
B.
Excellent. Thank you so much انكم ساهرتوا
شكرا لك يا دكتوره ناهد thank you لك والله كانت محاضره جميله جدا
دكتوره ناهد
يا شباب ما تمشوا لسه ال هناك رسلت لكم السويشن هو الفورم بتاع السويشن هو الريفيو بتاع المحاضره وبعدين ما هناخذ اسئله لانه الزمن يتاخر بس حيكون في تعقيب اسال الدكتور عبد الغني اذا عنده تعقيب انا عندي تعقيب برضه اخليه بس بالدكتور عبد الغني
دكتور عبد الغني شكله مش هيعمل حاجه ما اعرفه
خلاص قايته انا بس لحد ما يجي دكتور عبد الغني في حاجه بالنسبه للكلوزابين يعني اتس ا فيري فاليبل ميديكيشن ساعات ما بيكون عندك مراقه مثلا للعيان اتس ا فيري افكتيف ميديسن احنا عندنا عيانين ساعات بيكون مستنيين في المستشفى لشهور this is the only medication that works for them هو في الاخر المحاضره دي is how to يعني prescribe it in a very safer way ما تكون خايف منه في حاجه طالعه في الناس انه بتخاف من الكلوزابين اي زول بتاكيكارديا they stop a clozapine انت you just you need to be very safe and you need to know your medications very well عشان to be a very effective prescriber ما عشان تخاف انك تكتبه يعني دي في الاخر this is just a message يعني people should be prescribing clozapine if you did not prescribe clozapine بس ده شغال inpatient في حاجه غلط في حاجه بس اذا اضيفها اللي هي بس الواحده من السايد افكتس اللي هي is under recognized لكن it's very common هي النمونيا النمونيا يعني هسه it's been very recognized very often يعني almost between 17 to 34% من العيانين خلال سنه لسنه ونص they will develop pneumonia واحنا بنتكلم عن bacterial pneumonia الريسك بتاعات دائما بتكون من ساعات من السيديشن من السلايفيشن اكسسيف سلايفيشن اللي بيحصل زي كده ذيرز ذات ات نايت ات بريديسبوز ذم تو ساعات لاسبيريشن نمونيا اتس مور لايكلي ذان نوت فيري اتس بكتيريال غير كده زي ما بيقول في التايتريشن بتاع الميديكيشن ان ذا بيجيننج دائما بتحصل ساعات لانه بيحصل immunological هنا changes in the body بتخليهم more predisposed للنمونيا المشكله في النمونيا شنو انا بفتكر فيها انها اتس ات لوكس لايك مايوكاردايتس شير اول almost everything كويس تاكيكارديا فيفر تشست بين سويتنج فاتيج تايرنس يعني almost all the clinical symptoms غير كده ما كل النمونياز بيكون عندها مثلا positive changes في الاكس راي ساعات يعني almost 65% بيكون ظاهر عندهم حاجات في كميه كبيره almost 65% من الناس اللي عندهم نمونيا ساعات بتظهر فيهم الماركرز بتلقاه في المايوكارديتس اللي هي الهاي تروبونين هاي سي ار بي فايتس فيري problematic لانك انت ما عايز الليله توقف الميديكيشن ما عايز توقف الميديكيشن فور ايفر لسمبدي وذ نمونيا نمونيا لما تحصل بتكون بتعمل بريديسبوزيشن برضه تعمل للكلوزابين ليفل تو جو هاي فاحنا دايما لما نشوف عندنا هاي بيشنت وذ نمونيا اند كلوزابين يو اولويز هاف تو ريديوس ذا دوز اولموست باي هاف لانه بتعمل هنا انكريس ذا ليفل ممكن تعمل توكسيسيتي فدي بس جست ذس از ا كومن ثينج اباوت نمونيا يعني اي ونتد تو شير اباوت
Thank you so much, دكتور ياسر. يعني أنا بأكد على نفس الكلام اللي هو قاله بأمانة يعني الكلوزابين ده يعني زي ما بيقولوا مرات لايف سيفر كده يعني مع البيشنتس، بنكون تعبانين وما عارفين يعني هاو تو هيلب البيشنت، جربنا كميات من الادويه، لكن الناس يوجوالي زي ار ريلكتنت تو ستارت كلازابين لانهم بس خايفين من السايد افكتس بتاعته. لكن يعني مع بعض بس المعرفه حول انه هاو تو ستارت ات وكيف تمشي وشنو السايد افكتس وكيف تعالجها، يعني يو ويل هاف ا فيري جود دراج تو ديل ويز. وداير منكم شوية يعني تنظيم بس، وفي البداية بتحسوا بالغرابة من، لكن بعد شوية حتشوفوا الإفكت على البيشن وحتتعودوا على إنه هاو تو مينيتر هاو تو انيشيت، لكن without trying you cannot learn how to deal with clozapine، لكن it's really very good drug. دكتور عبد الغني
السلام عليكم.
تفضل.
السلام.
وعليكم السلام.
دكتور ياسر، دكتور ناهي، شكرا على المحاضرة الدسمة. بس أنا عندي شوية كومنت. إحنا يمكن أنا شخصيا عندي مرضى كثيرين بياخدوا كلوزابين وبيعملوا فحوصات مانسلي تقريبا كلهم مينتين، وما زالوا بيرسلوا لي بالواتس كل شهر تقريبا الفحوصات الروتينية بالذات السي بي سي. فالكومنت بتاعتي عادة إحنا وستارت with 12.5 مللي جرام. طبعا بنعمل جدول ستارتنج ات نايت، والجايد لاينز طبعا في اوت بيشنت حتى بتقول 6.125 اللي هي نص ساعه. اني واي الماكسيموم دوز طبعا في كل الريفرنسز يا 750 او 800 مللي جرام، وبراكتيكالي انا اي نيفر ريتش 6 يعني مور ذان 600 مللي جرام بير داي. عادة 150 200 300 بالكثير، دي المينتنس دوز. بالنسبة للسايد افكتس في حاجة مهمة، أنا أي وورن البيشنتس أباوت 3 ثينكس إف ذي ديفلوب هاي فيفر أند أور سور ثروت أور مونيليان انفكشن في الماوس. إيفري بيشنت بياخد كلوزابين شود بي وورد أباوت ذيس. وزي ما قال الدكتور ناهد، لو المريض وقف مور ذان 48 أورز هنعمل ري ستارتنج. بالنسبه للابيليبسي الكونفلشنز، اف البيشنت ديفلوب كونفلشنز ستوب الكلوز، الجايد لاين بيقول ستوب الكلوزابين فور 24 اورز اند ريستارت وذ لور دوز، مش الدوز اللي حصل فيها السيزر مع الصوديوم بايكلوريت. يمكن ثاني الكلوزابين في كاس وايز يا اخوانا، انا دائما بقول يمكن عندي قول الريجسترار دائما بيقول لي انه لا يعلى عليه كلوزابين، لا يعلى عليه يعني خلاص داخل حاجه ما في بعده حاجه لحد هسه جاتنا. واحنا لازم نفرق بين افيكاسي وافيشنسي وبوتنسي وافكتيفنس، وناس مختلفات انا ما في داعي اشرح لكم عشان الزوم متاخر، لكن تعرف الفرق بيناتهم. فافيكاسي وايز الكلوزابين لا يعلى عليه. السايد افكتس يمكن انا شخصيا حصلت لي يمكن اثنين او ثلاثه بتاعت كونفولشنز سيزرز وكنترول، وبعد ذاك وصل في الكلوزابين. بالنسبه للكونستيبيشن انا لا انساه ابدا، بالذات اول ما جيت كان عندي بيشن ريزيستنت واديته كلوزابين وتحسن معاه، لكن هي ديفلوب كونستيبيشن وبراه مشى الصيدليه جاب بارافين ليكويد ولا حاجه لاكسيتيف واخذ الجزازه كلها، وانفورشنتلي جاب دايريا اند هي باست. فعشان كده ما انصح كاتب كونستيبيشن. وبعد ذاك يعني مرضى كثيرين بيكون مشكله الكونستيبيشن، فهي كمان الناس برضو زي ما قال دكتور ناهد يظهر منها روتين. شكرا جزيلا.
شكرا جزيلا. دكتور عبد الغني موجود؟
نعم. شكرا جزيلا دكتور دكتور ناهد، فيري انفورماتيف ليكشر، يعني شرح الكلوزابين تماما. شكرا دكتور ياسر كل الحضور والانتر اكشن. كلوزابين باختصار از ا فيري جود دراج، بس كلوزابين از ا فيري جود دراج as long as we take the precautions. We don't admit patients. هنا ما عندنا احنا اللكجري بتاعتهم انه to admit patients for starting clozapine. We usually في السودان we start it as an outpatient طبعا، لكن ال ideal طبعا if you can afford to admit a patient. في السودان ذاته ما بيقف يقول لك عشان عايز تبدا ليه وده، ويقول لي والله عايز انكدك، ما حيرضى البيشنت في النهايه الادميشن، لانه حتى الفاميلي ما الادميشن متعب بالنسبه لهم. لكن حتى في ايرلند كنا وي ستارت كلوزابين زي ما قال دكتور حمد 6.25. المشكله في السودان في اقل دوز كان 25، يعني الناس كانت بتبتدي 12.5. Very nice lecture. شكرا ياسر، شكرا للجميع. و go and read something about clozapine and tardive dyskinesia. العلاقة بيناتهم شنو؟
شكرا.
ايوه
و I think يعني it is a good night و time to say good night.
Thank you so much. Have a good night.
شكرا على المحاضرة دكتور ناهد. احنا افتكر ما قفلنا الفيديو ولا قفلنا.
في بس نقطة يا ياسر،
ايوه
وانت وانا دايما بنلف عليها، فيديو